Good day. أهلا وسهلا بالجميع. Today I would like to address a couple of controversial topics regarding personal freedoms. I will start by telling a story about my compatriot Jackie Chamoun. This young lady is a Lebanese skier who competed at the Sochi Olympics. 3 years ago, she took nude photos for an Austrian magazine with other athletes in a mountainous region in Lebanon called Faraya. Now, before the Olympics, photos and videos of her behind the scenes have surfaced over the internet. One local TV station reacted by calling her a porn star. Then, outgoing sports minister Faisal Karami took it to another level by calling for an investigation by the Lebanese Olympic Committee. The girl, she apologized for all the controversy. So what do I think? Let me first point out, not that it matters, but first, it happened 3 years ago. Second, this also means nothing to me, but she did it for a foreign magazine, not Lebanese. Third, the photos put on the internet were never meant to be seen. Also, this does not matter to me. Now, when I say they do not matter to me, it does not mean they don't matter to others. With all that said, here's the problem I have. This local Al Jadid TV station called her a born star. Now think with me here while I compare a born star to Jackie Chamoun. A born star is someone paid to appear in adult videos, يعني to have the sex on the camera. Chamoun appeared nude for a magazine with the other athletes. How does that make her a born star? Satellite providers need to suspend broadcasting by Al Jadid because what they said was radical. Now the minister Karami, Bekshe, I mean, is something wrong with you mentally? Are you all there? Like people say in the West? What exactly is there to investigate? Huh? Explain to me, please. You want to view the pictures and videos so you can jerk off to them because your wife will divorce you for making such outlandish remarks? What is there to investigate other than the content itself? And what can you do with this content other than just look at it? Is someone breaking a law by appearing nude for a magazine? If they are professional athletes at a mountain resort, I am sure they are all 18 and up. The fact that a minister made an issue out of it reflects the problem with the Lebanese society. Like, okay, some people defended Chamoun by the whole campaign of stripping for Jackie and whatnot, but there were also people who were upset. These people have no right to be mad for any reason. There's no justification for it. Being mad at her is radicalism. And here is why. Did Jackie Chamoun take away your right to wear clothes when she took off hers? The answer is no! Was she committing indecent exposure? Was she running naked through the streets of fucking Beirut? The answer again is no! Moving on, another problem in Lebanon is the debate over the civil marriage. To me, I don't understand why people oppose it to begin with. For the idiots out there, civil marriage is a marriage performed, recorded, and recognized by a government official. Now, in normal countries like the United States, marriage is usually performed by religious figures who act in accordance to law. Civil marriage is optional. Even in some countries, civil marriage is mandatory. However, in fucked up countries like Lebanon, civil marriage only became legal this year, but I think it's not even passed in the parliament yet. Before, only religious authority could perform and register marriages. When the legislation was being passed, the Grand Mufti and even the Prime Minister were against it. Well, President Sulaiman said it was a very important step in eradicating sectarianism and solidifying national unity. The Grand Mufti said Muslim officials who support civil marriage will no longer be considered Muslim. Now, who does he think he really is? God? Who is he to decide who is he or not Muslim? He isn't the only religious figure in Lebanon getting involved in politics. The Maronite Church recently drafted a document describing it as a political roadmap for Lebanon. They got into how Lebanon should handle the political crisis, equal rights and representation between the Muslim and the Christian, the policy of neutrality, and the need to stay away from the foreign conflict with other things. The document itself is all right. Politicians, even a president, including the hypocrite own, was allied with Hezbollah, who, by the way, are fighting in another fucking country. But the problem is, why the church writing such a thing? See, this goes back to Lebanese society being fucked up. There needs to be a separation between the church and the state. The patriarch of the church is a politician. He's no different than Aoun or Hariri or even the Grand Mufti. I am very outspoken of these issues because I grew up in modern times. Things of the past are no longer right. There is no logic or reason to defend these archaic fucking institutions and laws that continue to brainwash our fucking citizens. Religion is really what plagues this fucking country, and the fact when you really look at it is, why is that Lebanon has never truly fucking been a peace? If you want to be smart ass with me, you say politics, but really politics are fueled by religion. Not one group creates a majority in Lebanon, so they all compete for the upper hand with the help of foreign backers. Saudi and Iran are pulling Lebanon apart. They have to put Lebanon in permanent fucking paralysis. The evidence lies in Dahia and Tripoli and on the fucking border with Syria. If I was the president of Lebanon, and if it was practical, keyword practical, I would declare Lebanon a secular state by outlawing the public practice of religion. All religious marriages will be outlawed, only civil marriages will be legal. And lastly, the church and Muslim higher councils will be abolished. Lebanon needs to become a country free of religion and sectarianism, free of hypocrisy and radicalism, free of animosity and resentment, free of corruption and bribery, and free of everything else that makes Lebanon what it is fucking today. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you.